So fever. Today we'll give some glimpse that how we can handle very simple fever or even influenza, dengue, malaria, or intermittent fever, remittent fever, whatever it, that how homoepathy can control very quickly. Doctors, whenever we are taking any acute case, that try to find out the exciting factor first. That dry, cold wind exposure, or after some mental trauma, after some physical trauma, after eating something excessively, then after that fever has started as a reaction. So any fever of the winter season, I'm telling, if it is come suddenly, abruptly with high rise of temperature and dry skin, think of homoepathy. Divide our medicine in such a way that you will be really amazed that how our system has divided our medicine. That medicine, fever comes in spring, fever during summer season, fever during rainy weather, fever after cold exposure, fever after wet cold exposure, fever after taking ice cream, fever after taking a spicy food, and even mental trauma. So let us see. In case of belladonna, what we will get? That here also we will get sudden high rise of temperature, 103, 104. It is not at all a low grade temperature, 99, 98. Abruptly it is coming. Then with intense headache, throbbing carotid, redness, but with moist perspiration over the skin. Not only that, you will get that during headache, in fever, mostly belladonna patient cannot lie down. Very difficult. That whenever the headache aggravates, and it aggravates when it is lying down. And mostly you will get that redness. So this is the sudden and violent attack, mostly aconite and belladonna we can think of. Now, a patient is telling that after cold exposure, that low grade of temperature, 99, 100, like that way, body ache, malaise, and tongue is not properly coated, little bit coated, and very, the patient is also mild, gentle, and some bukhar aata hai, bukhar ke liye hum kya karega, my body is paining, but performing everything slowly. So it is neither a stage of aconite, of sudden onset of aconite, nor it is slow, sluggish, dullness, dizziness. You will get it that most of the time this group of patients are very robust. And sometimes you will get that lean thin with tubercular background. Both the way you can think of ferrum pus when it is only the inflammation without any apparent symptom. Just simple, a starting point, acute inflammatory fever, just it is coming slowly, last 2 days I have some malaise, body ache, fever 99, 100. So neither it is covering the aconite, nor it is covering the next medicine we are discussing, that you are observing a child or a patient that in your clinic so much drowsy. You are asking the question and patient is telling yes, he is answering, but all you are observing in this way what I am doing. Then next, show your tongue, you are observing, so trembling of tongue, dullness, dizziness, trembling, patient is thirstless and a little bit diarrheic. And here also patient is desired to remain on bed. So this is a perfect picture of gelsemia. Dullness, dizziness, drowsiness, trembling of the tongue and thirstlessness and desire to remain on bed. Our next medicine will come, that gelsemium. Yes, doctor, it is a very good medicine or the starting medicine for measles. Mostly you will get this type of picture in measles. Dullness, dizziness, drowsiness, because toxic condition, it can be controlled very nicely with our gelsemium. Next medicine, the rain exposure. what I am telling, rain exposure. After that, patient whole night is tossing, changing the position very frequently. And you are observing, show your tongue, then you are seeing that red tips, the triangular tips on the tip of the finger with restlessness. Restlessness is the keynote indication of this medicine, and with muscle ache and body ache, the patient is telling, messaging, restless, better by warm application. We can think of rush drugs confidently. The next medicine is rush drugs, rush drugs, rush drugs. Most of the time, this muscular pain, it will be faded away, fever will subside, maybe with influenza, maybe with your dengue, whatever this rush drugs is one of the medicine. Another group of patient will show that even during acute attack of influenza or the inflammatory fever, maybe associated with even rheumatic fever also, that patient even unwilling to talk, unwilling to move, and desire absolute rest. Even the patient you are asking, show your tongue, the patient is getting irritating. He will show the tongue but with an irritating eyes. Then again he is going to lie down or taking rest. So irritability better by absolute rest or desire absolute rest, either mental or physical, not to be disturbed, constipated. And when you are asking, drink whatever your thirst during fever, the patient is taking a glass of water at a time, but with a long interval, with coated tongue. You are observing the tongue, here it is totally dry. In rush drugs it is moist, but here it is totally dry tongue, and we are prescribing dryonia. This, but our beauty is that sometimes you may get another picture, a combined picture of rush drugs and dryonia. Then what to do? Patient has desired to lie down, but lying down aggravating. And as I told, that bryonia is mostly a constipated medicine with constipation. But patient is telling, doctor, I feel better by movement of rush drugs, but I am constipated. In other words, doctor, I feel better if I on the bed, but I have loose stool. In acute condition, very rarely bryonia will show the loose stool. So this type of combined picture of rush drugs and bryonia, either in physical level or in mental level. I desire to lie down. I have a desire to lie down. I should take rest. I know that I have to take rest. But if I take rest, it is aggravating. So this is the conflict, and this is the combined picture where bryonia and rush drugs both are coming. And the medicine which is really a gem for this fibromuscular ailments, rheumatism, fever, muscle ache, the medicine is phytolog. So by this way, even very common fever we can control very nicely. Now taking for granted, take it that how quickly, even the name of the disease, when it is dengue, the body ache is the very prominent, and body ache, you are observing excessive body ache, but you are observing along with that, this vomiting is prominent. Too much vomiting with chilliness. And what you are observing, that patient is talking too much. We know that lachesis are garrulous, but mother is telling, my child, or patient is telling, or patient's near relative is telling, doctor is talking, my patient, itna baat karta hai, we are really fed up. So during chilliness, patient is talking. Loquacity during chilliness, take the rubric, and most probably podopylum will come, Eupatorium percolatum will come. So by this way, the mental aspect you have to take. Now a patient is telling obstinate headache with denginess, body ache, bitter taste. That is another group, and most probably it is one of the gem what homeopathy doctors are rarely using, that is polyporous. Polyporous is a really gem for dengue. So like this, we have no specific, but always think that symptom complex. Dear doctors, take one or two symptoms of mental aspect, take peculiar symptoms of modality or in which position patient is sitting or getting comfort or discomfort, take this and with the thermal reaction, and definitely you will get the desired result. Not only that, even after dengue or influenza, when patients are suffering from rheumatic complaint, weakness, persistent weakness, you have to take the help of natron salicylicum. Persistent weakness after influenza, adverse effect of the influenza, like that solanum lycopersicum, our tomato, that muscular pain left after influenza, not only influenza, any viral fever, when the muscle pains are there, we can think of lycopersicum. Like this, profound neurological weakness, nervous prostration, unwilling to talk, no sleep, with weakness of the extremities, and with offensive discharges, all discharges are very offensive, putrid, think of Kelly-Fos. Not only that, when patient is telling doctor, my child's measles are subsided, that patient is suffering from cough, persistent cough. We have lot of medicine, Sanguinaria canadensis, Squilla, Drosera. We have to differentiate. Doctor, homeopathic materia medica, it's a treasure. It is full of gems, but we have to take that which gem is really needed to combat their disease. Thank you.